In this video, we're going to quickly cover how to write numbers in scientific notation, and then we're going to cover how to convert numbers in scientific notation back into standard form. And as we can see at the top here, the main idea with scientific notation is that any number can be written as a number between 1 and 10 multiplied by a power of 10. When I say between 1 and 10, I'm not including 10 itself. So what we're talking about here is a single digit before the decimal point and then multiplied by 10 to some power. And the basic idea behind this is that, for example, the number 1,000 can be written as a power of 10, as 10 to the third. So that's our basic key to writing large numbers as powers of 10. And then a number like 1,000th, 0.001 or 1,000th, well, I realize 1,000 in the denominator is a 10 to the third in the denominator, but that simplifies to 10 to the negative 3. And so large numbers will have positive exponents of 10 and small numbers will have negative exponents of 10. So let's apply this to the first example. I'm given the number 43,500. I'm told to assume that 5 is the last measured digit here, and I'll explain why that matters in a moment. And I'm trying to write this in scientific notation. And I immediately realize, oh, this thing is just 4.35 times 10,000. But 10,000 can be written as a power of 10. And I've got my answer, 4.35 times 10 to the fourth. Now, why does it matter that we were told that 5 was the last measured digit? Well, the standard notation is ambiguous. When I see 43,500, I can't tell whether or not that number was rounded to the hundredths place, or whether it was rounded to the tenths place, and it just happened to be a zero in that place, or even if it was rounded to the ones place. So when we're told that 5 is the last measured digit, we're being told that we have 3 significant digits here, and the scientific notation should have 3 digits in it. If we were told that the tens place was the last measured place value, we could simply write the scientific notation as 4.350. times 10 to the fourth. And this is a major advantage of scientific notation over the standard notation. The trailing zeros in the standard notation are ambiguous, but in scientific notation, however many digits you have in front of that power of 10, that's how many sig figs you have. Let's take a look at part B. This time we have a small number, 0.0052, and I could write that as 5.2 times 0.001 or 1,000th, and then I remember 1,000th is 10 to the negative 3, and we're done with that one. Now, I do want to point out that in practice, you're probably going to find the power of 10 by counting decimal places. So for part A, I would start with my decimal point after the ones place, and then count how many places does it take to get to the point where there's only one digit left in front of the decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces, and that's why I have a 10 to the fourth. For the small number in part B, 1, 2, 3 spaces to get the decimal after the first non-zero digit. And because it's a small number, that's a 10 to the negative 3. Now let's go the other way around in part 2. In part A, I'm told the speed of light is 2.998 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. And because I have a 10 to the 8th, it means that that decimal bouncing idea had to happen 8 times to arrive at the scientific notation. And we're just going to reverse the process by bouncing the other way 8 spaces. So I go 1, 2, 3, and then I'm out of digits, so I need to start putting in placeholders. So here's a 4. 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then I should have commas in here, and I'll rewrite the answer just to clean it up. And this is 299,800,000. Don't forget the units, meters per second. In part B, we take a very small number in scientific notation. So the diameter of the hydrogen atom is 1.06 times 10 to the negative 10 meters. And again, I'll just think of this in terms of bouncing the decimal place. And this time I'm going the opposite direction in order to arrive at a very small number. So I bounce 1 decimal place, and then 2, and I need a placeholder, 3, and so on. And so I arrive at this very small decimal with 9 leading zeros before I get to the 106. And I'll clean it up and put units on it. And we're done with that one. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.